afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Grace Episcopal Church. And especially for you, those who have not been able to come for a while, it's great to see you, Jenny and Betty and Molly and Peggy. Thank you for being with us today. As we begin our service, we've been having some technical difficulties, and I apologize. We're going to get that worked out for our live streaming purposes. So that will be done here shortly this week. So we apologize that this is being recorded and being posted later. We begin our service on page 1 of your worship aid, page 1 at the top left corner. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John chapter 1, verses 8 and 9. If you are able, let us now stand or kneel, whichever is more prayerful for you, and let us confess our sins to God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our collect for this day was sent to you virtually as well, at the top of your second insert page. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you know that we have no power in ourselves to help ourselves. Keep us both outwardly and our bodies and inwardly in our souls, that we may be defended from all adversities which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we hear God's sacred word.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verses 1 through 2, 5 through 9. So now, Israel, give heed to the statutes and ordinances that I am teaching you to observe, so that you may live to enter and occupy the land that the Lord, the God of your ancestors, is giving you. You must neither add anything to what I command, nor take away anything from it, but keep the commandments of the Lord your God, with which I am charging you. See, just as the Lord my God has charged me, I now teach you statutes and ordinances for you to observe in the land that you are about to enter and occupy. You must observe them diligently, for this will show your wisdom and discernment to the peoples, who, when they hear all these statutes, will say, "Surely this great nation is a wise and discerning people. For what other great nation has a God so near to it as the Lord our God is whenever we call to him? And what other great nation has statutes and ordinances as just as this entire law that I am setting before you today? But take care and watch yourselves closely, so as neither to forget the things that your eyes have seen, nor let them slip from your mind all the days of your life. Make them known to your children and your children's children." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our psalm today is Psalm 78, verses 1 through 6, found on the insert that was sent to you virtually, also in your Book of Common Prayer, or also in your Holy Scriptures on page 694 in your Book of Common Prayer. Psalm 78, verses 1 through 6. We'll read these in unison. Hear my teachings, O my people. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will declare the mysteries of ancient times, that which you have heard and known, and what your forefathers have told us. We will not hide from their children. We will recount to generations to come the praiseworthy deeds and the power of the Lord, and the wonderful works he has done. He gave his decrees to Jacob and established a law of Israel, which he commanded them to teach their children, that the generations to come might know, that the children yet unborn, that they are in turn, might tell it to their children. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Christ. This is from Matthew chapter 5, verses 17 through 19. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all that is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. May what I am about to say be in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. When we listen to our scriptures today, they kind of give us some directions of how we should be leading our lives of faith. Sometimes, in many respects, we sometimes find it difficult to be faithful. I'll tell you a little story. There was once a little girl who saw her father having to get up early in the morning every day during the week. And finally she said to him, "Why do you get up so early? Why don't you take another hour and a half and just stay here at home and relax and before you have to rush off? Don't you want to be with us?" And he said to his daughter, "The reason I am leaving early is so that I can go to church and spend time in prayer and to be with our worship, our weekday service." His daughter was so impressed. It really changed her outlook on what her father was about as a person. He was not just a hard-working father figure and a man, but he was also somebody who actually thought his faith was really important to him, that he would actually go to church and worship and spend time with God. Now, we don't have to go to church to spend time with God, but it is a place where we can find our time in communal prayer, like this, is important, like on Sundays as well. Weekday services or Sunday services are vitally important to our faith life as a community. So Jesus is telling in our passage from Matthew's gospel today, he's reminding us that it is important that the work we do in faith is also an outstretch of what we do and we practice. In other words, do people see that we are a faithful person in our actions and what we do with our lives, what we say in our conversations with others? Jesus is saying, reminding us today, that it is a reflection on us as we prepare for the kingdom of God, which is the heavenly promise of our faith that Jesus gave to us of the resurrection. In the season of Lent, it is a time for us to reflect on how have I been working on my faith life in my real world, in my family life, and am I practicing those things? God only knows it is difficult to do it in a pandemic. But more importantly, are you making the effort to participate in the life of your community, of our faith church community here at Grace Church, which has been hard to do when we've been gone for almost over a year at times here and there, but important now as we start to come back with our vaccinations to ourselves, are we making this a priority? Maybe taking time and just spending time at home watching this virtually and praying with the people who are online. And it doesn't have to be with us here at Grace Church. It can be with another faith community, maybe the National Cathedral or whatever it might be. God is calling us to a higher calling as Christians. He's asking us to be faithful and to make it known to those that we are around. Even though we don't do it perfectly, the idea is that we try. Amen. We can now continue our service on page one of your worship aid. At the top of the page one on the right column, prayers of the people, form three. If you'd please stand with me and let us offer our prayers as people of God. Prayers of the people, form three. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church, that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you. Your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world. There may be justice and peace on the earth. Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake. Our works may find favor in your sight. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. Give to the departed eternal rest. Let light perpetually shine upon them. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. If you'd like to mention a person by name at this time or an event that you're having at this time, let us offer those prayers as well. Yes. Pray for all those intentions in our book of prayerful intentions. For Charles Turok. For Lori Copeland, who's having a procedure today. For my wife, Susie, who's frozen shoulder. For all those who are struggling with behavioral health issues. Especially we pray for our teachers as they go back to school in person this week. And for our students and all families. We pray for those who are struggling financially. Wondrous God, we ask you to hear the prayers that we have spoken, both out loud and those still in our recesses of our hearts and minds. Bless us this day and hear them and answer them according to your will. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Peace be with you. Now at this time, as we extend the communion rail to those who are not with us in person, let us kneel or remain standing, and let us offer our prayer of the extension of our communion rail in this altar. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. We are on the top of page 2 on the second right-hand column. Let us pray. Lord, you have taught us to seek you and to find you in the bread and the wine of your table. Season after season, we have returned to you there. But now we are living in a season of isolation from one another, from the lives we have known, and even from the community of your table. And so we lament. Turn to me and have mercy, for I am lonely and oppressed. Hear my prayer and my cry. Be not silent at my tears. For surely, Lord, we are not alone. Formed in your image, you met us through your Christ in the womb of Mary, beside the sea, at Golgotha, and in every tomb. Through the mystery of his death and resurrection, we are now one with you. In our days, as with a mother's milk, you have been forming our bodies to become your body through the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Our flesh is now yours, shaped for these days in which we are living. Nourished by Christ, teach us also to be broken with Christ and shared with his hungering world. Soften our hearts and strengthen our resolve. Meet us on the road and open our eyes to see afresh the abundance of your grace, alive and at hand throughout your sacred and hurting world. Through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. We continue our celebration at the bottom of page 2 in the second right-hand column, Eucharistic Prayer A. Please stand, wherever you might be. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You bid your people, faithful people, cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that in fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace for which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed it is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Top of page 3. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all, he stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of the new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at that last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy upon us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us thy peace. The gifts of God for you, the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Time I will come to each of you to bring and distribute Holy Communion. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, Peggy. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, Molly. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, Betty. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven, Jenny. us offer our prayer after Holy Communion, found on the bottom of page 3 in the second column, right-hand column. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with the spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Let us go forth and be the church. Thanks be to God. Thank you so much for joining me this afternoon. I hope you have a wonderful afternoon. Please know you're welcome to join us for a Bible study this evening at 5:30. That virtual link was sent to you yesterday as well. Have a blessed week and a holy Lent as well.